Hello, how are you doing today? Had a little bit of technical difficulties just then, so apologies if you're waiting and I don't know if I was popping up or not. I'm really not too sure what's going on. So today I wanted to do a short practice with you, and this practice is something that you can fit into your busy schedule. So a couple of things that I get from students about the difficulties of practicing at home is not enough time, and this is why we're going to do 10-15 minutes, and also not enough space as well. This is quite a common issue, and I'm going to do this yoga practice, very small area where you can sit, so you don't even actually need the space of a yoga mat to do this practice. And if you're going to be joining me live, please let me know, comment below. And if you're not able to practice with me now, you can I'm going to post the replay for you guys to do later. Now, if you want to save this video, there is a save button, or what you can do is share it onto your personal Facebook page, and then it's saved on your personal page rather than scrolling back through trying to find the video. So this is one way of keeping hold of this mini yoga practice today. So I hope you're having a good day. Northampton, we have actually got some sunshine today, yay! Which I'm sure a lot of you guys are really happy about. I am really happy about this as well. So what I'd like you to do is come into a comfortable seated position, and this is comfortable for you. So you might want to sit cross-legged if that's available. Now, if you're finding that your knees are really lifted up, your hips are very tight in your thighs, it's a good idea to raise yourself up a little higher. So I've got myself a cushion and I'm going to sit up on the cushion. This is quite helpful for me as well, for my hips, where I've been having a little bit of trouble. So, this is one option. Another option is to sit kneeling, or you can have the legs forward and the knees bent. So, whichever option is available for you to sit up nice and tall. And we're all different, we've got different bodies. No posture is better than the other, and you're not a better person if you can do cross-legged. So, the yoga practices I teach are for well-being, they're not for any aesthetic reasons or looking good or fancy yoga poses. Although they're great, they're just not what I teach. So come into that comfortable seated position for me today, please. And so the back is nice and tall, shoulders are back and down, and we're going to gently tuck the chin under. So just bring the chin towards the throat, so the gaze is slightly down. And we're going to bring the left hand into the lap and place the right hand on top, thumbs gently touching. Place the hands into the lap, and then if you're able to close the eyes, close your eyes. And we're going to take a minute to center ourselves. So, eyes closed. And preferably breathing in and out through the nose. Although, if you have a cold, please breathe through the mouth. Just breathing naturally and normally, and noticing this flow of air coming in and out through the nose. And as you remain nice and tall and seated, I would like you to just allow the muscles in the face to soften and relax. So, noticing if there is any frown, you can soften, relaxing the jaw, the throat. Moving down the shoulders, the arms, hands, and fingers. Softening the chest, the abdomen, the lower belly. And as you're breathing in, really allowing your lower belly to expand. And as you exhale, there is this gentle release. And then relaxing the hips, moving down the legs, the feet, the toes. And then relaxing the back of the body, so the back of the head, the neck, the back, buttocks, the backs of the legs, and the soles of the feet. So the body is alert and upright, but we are experiencing this quality of gentleness, of softness within the body. And continue to observe this flow of breath, breathing in, breathing out. And when your mind starts to wander, I'd like you to gently guide your awareness back onto the breath. So you might have awareness for two breaths and then you start to think about something that's normal. Just keep observing this natural flow of the breathing. And then we're going to, so keep the eyes closed, rub the palms of the hands together vigorously. And then placing the palms of the hands over the eyes gently. A little bit of pressure on the cheeks. And then allow the light to start to come in, bring the hands away from the body. Okay, so I like to begin every single yoga session quietly, either laying down, resting pose, or in a meditation focus on the breathing. The reason is we're all very busy, very stressful lives, and we need to just take this time to almost gather all our energy, all of our scattered thoughts, and focus on the breath. So from here, what I'd like to do is bring the legs forward. So I'd like you to keep a bend in the knees and have the heels connected to the floor and the toes lifting up, and we're just going to gently slide down the legs into a forward fold position. Drop the head down, and I want you to allow the face to soften. So again, be aware of where you're holding tension. Are you holding tension in your shoulders? Are they lifting up around the ears? Are you holding in your tummy? So breathe in and out really fully, really deeply. And experiencing each inhale as a really nourishing breath for your body. On the in-breath, we're going to start to make our way back up into an upright position. So you can keep the legs in this position if this is correct for your knees or hips or any other seated position. We're going to gently ease the shoulders and so gently easing the shoulders back and down, and then we'll go forwards, and then gently taking the head around in a circle, breathing in and out through the nose. My head's getting in the way today. And then going the other direction, trying to do it without getting hair in my face, and then come back into the middle. So taking the left hand onto the floor, staying on the fingertips so this left arm can stay fairly straight. On the in-breath, lift the right arm up, and then we're going to start to come over towards the left. You can slide that left arm away from you a little bit if that is suitable. So breathe in fully, deeply, and you want to feel a bit of a stretch, but you don't want to be forcing and straining. Bringing this aggressive nature. So think about ease in each pose. On the in-breath, we're going to make our way over to the side and exhaling over to the right. Notice the breath. Are you holding the breath? Is it shallow? I think about this quality of softness and ease. And then on the in-breath, we're going to make our way up. Bring the hands in front of you. And we're coming to a forward fold position with the legs crossed if that's available. And again, just allowing gravity to bring you forwards. Drop the shoulders, drop the head down. Breathe in and out fully. And then on the in-breath, we're going to make our way back up. We're going to switch the legs over. Switch the legs, and then we're going to bow forwards with gentleness and ease. Drop the head, breathing fully. And then making our way back up. Sorry, I keep getting lots of things popping up. And then from here, we're going to bring the soles of the feet together. So we're creating a diamond, but I want you to slide the feet a little bit further away. So I don't want the feet really close in towards you. Slide the feet away so we can slide the hands down the legs towards the feet, drop the head down. And again, notice the shoulders. So in my classes, a lot of people have very tense shoulders. Just soften down and notice how you feel when you bring this ease. Breathe in and out fully, really nourishing breath. And then on the in-breath, we're going to press into the floor, make our way back up, help the knees come back in together, bring the hands behind you, and we're going to take the knees from side to side. And then slide the feet away from you, so your legs are fairly straight. We're going to cross, so I'm not sure if you can see, but I'm going to explain. So you're crossing your right leg over your left, and then really lift up nice and tall, and we're going to turn and twist to the right side. So you're turning to the right, take the right hand behind you, left arm is crossing over to the leg, really lift and lengthen and look over the right shoulder. Take a few breaths here. And then on that inhale, we're going to make our way around to the front, slide your hand down that top leg, drop the head down. And then on the in-breath, coming back up. So we're going to change over. Left leg crossed over the right, lifting up nice and tall. Taking the left hand behind you, staying on the fingertips, the right hand crossing over. Lift and lengthen and turn and look over the left shoulder. Breathe in and out fully. And then we're going to make our way round to the front. Slide that hand down the leg, drop the head down. And then on the in-breath, make our way back up. Come into a comfortable seated position. We're going to finish off here. I'm going to come into a kneeling pose because I'm trying to do less cross-legged. It's not really great for my hips doing it all of the time. So we're going to finish off briefly with a breathing meditation once more that we did at the beginning. Same hand gesture position, so left hand resting in the lap, right hand on top, thumbs connected, sitting up nice and tall, lengthen through the body, close the eyes, soften the shoulders, relax the jaw, awareness on the breath, relaxing all the muscles in the body. And enjoy this time to just focus on the breath. All we have to do is breathe, so there's nothing to do. Nowhere to go, nobody to please in this moment. Just watching and observing the sensations. Nostrils as the air comes in and out through the nose. And notice if you feel any different from when we started. So we've only done 5 or 10 minutes, but we don't need long to change our energy, our mind, our body. We just need a regular practice and a little bit of motivation. And then when you're ready, we're going to open the eyes and connect back together. Okay, so I hope you have enjoyed this really little mini yoga practice that you can very easily do at home. So I know it takes quite a lot of motivation to get you going doing it at home. So this is why I wanted to do this video today. And each week, this time each week, I'm generally free. So I'm going to come in and do a mini yoga practice for you guys. So if you want to join any of my in-person offerings, you're very welcome to join me, my classes, one-to-ones, and I'll just post the link in the video. So thank you so much. Share with anyone that you know needs to slow down, who has stress, anxiety. The practice that I teach is really quite helpful. So thank you so much. I can't see if anybody has commented. There's some of you watching quietly, but I hope you're able to join along, and I'm going to post the replay. Have a lovely Wednesday, and I will see you guys soon.